I'm doing very well, thank you very much. I'm in a wheelchair, but I can get around. And I'm very pleased with how home looks. I haven't been in the buildings, but I've been out and around, and it looks beautiful.
What motivated you or led you to become an activist or to do some of the things that you have done to make the world better?
My real inspiration in life has come from the belief in the Bible and in Jesus Christ. And everywhere I went, because one thing I could do is work, is I work with people. And so I went from my family to the nuns to the home co-op. And I thought, well, if I'm going to work for anybody, it might as well be poor people. So we tried to come up with some way that was honest and fair. The real interest we had was to really make life better for people. And a home, that was one of the origins of the inspiration for home, is to help people and help them not make it better for ourselves. Everything we did at home, there was all of the ingredients of stuff that Maine poor people did.
I'm sure you encountered a number of challenges as you did this work. What kept you motivated and what continued to give you courage to do the work you're doing?
I try to practice the presence of God, but then other people, other human beings who were really good.
I'd like to say that we had a young man, his name was Ray. That was his first name. And I just know that he'd been living by getting his hand in a dumpster and finding food. And he apparently had no place to live, so we took him in. He had cancer in the carotid artery, eventually it moved to the other side. Well, he died a couple weeks ago. And I just want to say that it's the richness of human beings that have come to home, and I like Ray, have just come. And he was such a beautiful person. I couldn't believe that he could be outside and not having a place to live, because he was so beautiful.
Right.
He was only 42 when he died. I grew to love him, and he was so courteous and helpful. And he is typical of the people that I've met through home that I grew. You fall in love with them. You never don't think of them.
Yes.
So I'm really grateful to God for that. And I'm grateful to God for the richness that's come into my life because of the human beings that are there now and those that have moved on to better things.
Our invitation to love God and to love our neighbor as ourselves. And we have such a wonderful example in the parable of the Good Samaritan. Everyone is our neighbor. And when you love someone as good as yourself, you want them to have what you have.
What advice would you give to young people today? There's a lot of divisiveness in our world right now, and people who have, you know, really differing views.
Doing basically cuts down the separation among us. You know, if you're loading a truck with firewood, you can't sit there and argue about which way to stack it. You got to stack the wood. So it breaks down the divisiveness among us if we do things that we can do together. For heaven's sakes, don't sit and talk. Get up and do it.
Do you think we've lost some ability to love each other? Is that what you're saying?
If we look at the inequity in society, it's just awful. And to think of all of the beautiful minds that are wasted that never get further education. I mean, we're worried about the people in Afghanistan who can't go to college. But what about the people here? All those beautiful minds wasted.
Thank you so much, Lucy, for talking with me.